AI skills are hot right now, and it's not just a passing trend. By the year 2030, jobs in AI research and advanced computing are expected to grow 26%, and that may even be a conservative estimate. One role that's becoming more and more popular is the AI engineer. The experts who help build tools like ChatGPT, the Netflix recommendation algorithm, and the AI chatbots you see on websites. So, how do you become an AI engineer? And how long does it take? In this video, I'll share a clear step-by-step roadmap you can follow. But first, what exactly is AI engineering? AI engineering is all about building and deploying systems and applications that use artificial intelligence. It combines computer programming, data, and machine learning to make smart technologies like self-driving cars or customer service chatbots. These systems are designed to perform tasks that would usually require human intelligence, such as understanding speech, recognizing images, or making decisions. In doing so, AI engineers help businesses work more efficiently, develop innovative products, and solve complex problems. If you want a more detailed explanation? I've got a separate video focusing on what an AI engineer actually does. You find the link in the description below this video. But for now, let's get into our roadmap. First up, step one, learn Python and programming fundamentals. If you're serious about becoming an AI engineer, your first step is to learn Python. Python is the go-to language for building AI systems. It's the foundation for nearly every major tool, framework, and service in the AI ecosystem. And it's especially important for AI engineering. Whether you're integrating AI APIs, deploying models into production, or building AI-powered applications from the ground up, Python is the backbone of modern AI development. And Python's great. It's clean, it's beginner-friendly, and it's incredibly versatile. Want to train a model to recognize cat photos? Python. Want to build a chatbot or analyze data to detect fraud? You guessed it, Python again. So where to begin? Start with core programming concepts such as variables, loops, functions, and data structures like lists and dictionaries. Then move on to libraries like NumPy and Pandas. These will help you to handle and manipulate data, which is a big part of what AI engineers do on a day-to-day basis. If you're taking a course, Python will be covered extensively in the curriculum. Otherwise, check out Kaggle's free Python track or search for free Python tutorials on YouTube. Step 2. Learn web basics, Git, and SQL. Once you've got a handle on Python, the next step is to learn some essential tools and technologies that support real-world AI projects. First up, web basics. This includes things like HTML, CSS, and HTTP. These will help you understand how the web works, which is super useful because most AI models end up being integrated into websites or apps. Next, get comfortable using APIs, which are how AI models are typically accessed in real-world applications. An API is basically how different systems talk to each other. Think of it like a waiter at a restaurant. You give them your order, they pass it on to the kitchen, and then they bring your food out. In tech, APIs do the same thing. They take a request from one system, send it to another system, like your AI model, and return the response. So, if you want to plug your AI model into something useful, like a chatbot, a website, or a mobile app, APIs are how you make that happen. You'll also want to learn Git and GitHub, the industry standard tools for version control. They basically let you keep track of your code over time, like saving different versions of a document. Finally, SQL. SQL stands for Structured Query Language, and it's used to communicate with databases. If your AI project needs to pull data from a big customer database or write new data back, you'll use SQL. Just like Python, it's a skill that shows up in tons of AI-related jobs. If you're following a structured AI engineering course, you'll find all of these skills covered in the curriculum. If you're teaching yourself, look for beginner-friendly tutorials on YouTube or check out Kaggle, W3 Schools, and SQL Bolt. As always, I drop those links in the video description. On to step 3, dive into machine learning fundamentals. Now you're ready to explore machine learning, the core of AI engineering. Start by learning the basics of what machine learning is, how it works, and when to use it. Then dive into key concepts such as supervised versus unsupervised learning, regression, classification, and evaluation metrics. Once you've got the theory down, try to build your first simple models using a library called scikit-learn. For example, you could train a model to predict house prices based on things like location, size, and number of bedrooms, a classic beginner project. Scikit Learn makes it easy to build and test models like this with just a few lines of code. Use Jupyter Notebooks to write and run your code, take notes and visualize your results all in one place. It's perfect for learning and iterating quickly. Check out Google's free machine learning crash course and use Kaggle to practice with real datasets. Step 4. Master prompt engineering. With the rise of large language models like ChatGPT, prompt engineering has become a key skill. This is all about writing effective prompts that guide the model to give you the results you want, whether that's summarizing text, generating code, or answering questions. As an AI engineer, you might use tools like ChatGPT-4 to build chatbots, writing assistants, or internal tools. So understanding how to design and iterate on prompts is a big advantage. Start by reading OpenAI's cookbook on prompt engineering. Then get hands-on with the tools like ChatGPT or Claude. Try writing prompts for different use cases, like a travel planner, a coding helper, or a customer support bot. See how small changes in wording affect the model's responses and start to get a feel for what works. Next up, step 5. Build backend applications. Now it's time to turn your machine learning models into real usable software. This means building backend applications, the part of a program that runs behind the scenes and handles tasks like making predictions or managing data. You might remember we talked about APIs back in step 2, and that's exactly what you're building now. The goal is to wrap your machine learning model in an API so that other programs or users can interact with it. So instead of running a script locally, you're now creating something that could power a chatbot, a website, or even a real product feature. Start by learning Flask or Fast API through beginner tutorials on YouTube. Then try building a simple app, like a movie recommendation tool or a tool that predicts house prices based on user input. These small projects will teach you how to connect your model to a real app and make it usable for others. You'll also get hands-on experience of testing and deploying your code, which are the key skills for getting your work out into the real world. Now let's move on to step 6, creating real-world projects and building your portfolio. Once you've got the foundations, it's time to show employers what you can do. Start building projects that address real-world problems and, most importantly, share them. Upload your code on GitHub. Write short case studies explaining what you built and why, and try to solve challenges on sites like Kaggle and Hugging Face. This is ultimately how you stand out to recruiters and prove your skills. If you need some project ideas to get you started, try building an AI-powered chatbot for an e-commerce website, a tool that detects fake news, or a resume screening tool that ranks candidates based on certain keywords. Use your imagination and have fun with it. It's all about experimenting, problem solving, and getting as much hands-on practice as possible. Now on to step 7, applying for entry-level jobs. Once you've got a few solid projects under your belt, start applying for jobs. You don't have to wait until you feel 100% ready. Entry-level roles are exactly that, a starting point. Look for roles like Junior AI Engineer, Gen AI Developer, or Prompt Engineer. You can also search for job titles such as Python Developer, Backend Engineer, or AI Researcher. The title itself is not so important, as long as you're focusing on roles that align with your skills, interests, and career goals. But be warned, the AI job market can be confusing. If you'd like more advice for your job search, check out my roundup of the fastest growing AI jobs right now. I've also covered AI engineering salaries in a separate video, so watch that to get informed before you go for interviews. And finally, step 8, and this one's optional. Level up with the certification. Another step you might consider is leveling up with the certification. This is entirely optional, but it's definitely worth thinking about if you want to specialize or give your resume a boost. If you study AI engineering with Masterschool, for example, you'll also have the option to get industry-recognized certifications like the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner Qualification or the PCAP Certified Associate Python Programmer Certificate. But as I say, these aren't essential for getting started. It's perfectly fine if you want to focus on building your core skills first. But if you're looking to dive deeper into a specific area or target a certain role in AI, additional certificates can be helpful. This leads us to another important topic. What's the best way to learn all the skills we've covered so far? Let's consider your options. What's the best route for you? If you want to become an AI engineer, there are a few different routes to consider, And the best route for you really depends on your personal preferences and your goals. If you've already got some foundational knowledge and you can trust yourself to stay motivated and disciplined, you might opt for the self-taught route. In that case, you can follow our roadmap and piece together your own curriculum with online resources. But if you're coming in as a newbie, I'd strongly recommend taking a proper course. This will provide structure, expert guidance, and hands-on learning, and you'll often get support through career coaching and job placement. Masterschool offers a really thorough and practical program, and if you live in Germany and you're currently unemployed, you could get the course fully paid by the German government. Finally, there's the degree route, but this is the most expensive and time-consuming, and it's just not necessary for most AI jobs. Think about your budget, your schedule, and how you learn best. Then go from there. So, there's your roadmap for how to become an AI engineer. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe and check out the video description for all those links I mentioned. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video.